Hi everyone. Now the flip learning class 4, number 4 is this. This particular class I am going to discuss about the control system. Actually our subject is instrumentation and control system. First 4.5 units we have completely discussed about the different types of instruments. Instruments used for displacement measurement, temperature measurement, pressure measurement, level measurement, etc., etc. Now we are going to talk about the control system. So how to develop the system to control the process. This control system, we have the following topics. First one is the control system, introduction about the control system. We need to understand what is meant by control, how to develop the system like this. Then second topic, we are going to talk about open and closed system. So classification of control system is open system and closed system. We are going to learn in terms of comparative way to attain the higher end bloom taxonomy. Then the third topic is elements of control system. What are the elements available to control the system? Then we are going to the servo control and automatic control system also there. It is not mentioned in the syllabus. However, we need to discuss something. Then temperature, speed, servo control mechanism. By using servo control mechanism, how to control the temperature, speed and position. I am going to discuss with you some real-time example, which is a little bit away from our textbook level. Finally, we are going to discuss about the advantages. Right, now the elements of the control system. What are the elements available? Or before that, we need to see the introduction. First, we need to know about what is meant by system. Then how to form the system, then how to design the system to control our requirement. A system is an assemble of devices, component, etc. System is nothing but we have a number of devices, component, equipments, devices. We need to connect together, we need to integrate together. Then we need to get integrate to perform a specific task. What is called system? This particular system produce an output corresponding to the input. Whatever input you are giving to the system, correspondingly it will deliver the output. For example, we take a thermometer and a mass spring damper system can be identified as a system. So here I am going to explain the thermometer, how a thermometer system works. The thermometer has an input of x theta temperature, the output y is length of the mercury. So temperature, we have a system, I think the thermometer, it is worked in zeroth law of thermodynamics, you know. Zeroth law of the thermodynamics, system A and B is a dependent. One is thermometer, another one is body, third one is mercury. Three different systems are there. Here, based on the temperature, body temperature is, we are putting into the temperature, thermometer sensor. So that what happened, depending upon the temperature, the mercury level, it will increase. So therefore, the movement of the mercury, movement, the distance moved by the mercury, it is the indicator. So this is the way you can measure the system. Next one is, first we seen about system, we have seen a real-time example. Next, control. What is meant by control? The control implies regulate, direct or command. Control is not that much easy task, which is associated with the following elements. One is regulate, direct, command. A control system may be thus, a control system may be defined as the an assemblage of devices and components connected or related so as to command, direct or regulate it self or another system. So this is the definition for control system. Assembling the devices and component with respect to the command, direct, regulate, and self to self or other system. You take a simple example of our switch, electrical on-off system, electrical power on-off system. Here you look at this diagram. Here you have a switch. Here you can give the two type of input, on, off. Whenever it is in off position, you can turn on. Whenever you on, then what happened? Your power is on, so that equipment like fan, something will be activated. Then at the end of our service, suppose then if you want to stop, you give input as a off, so that what happened? The power will cut off, so that your device, appliance, something, it will come to original position, it will come to rest position. So this is the typical example to understand the control system, simple control system. The control system, it's a very simple one. It is having many complicated control systems also. Complicated system, if you want to say an example of our ISRO, recently our final year student, we visited the ISRO. There we have seen central control system. So there they are completely controlling the things. Like you have a launch pad, from the launch pad the vehicle is released and it is taking upward movement, and each and every period of time, right, the various component is dismantled, finally it is reaching its position. Then later on another control system is there they will control the position, so that what happened, it will kept in appropriate position to take photograph, to take test, and they are getting the result to the system. So from the information, mainly they are getting the information about the climate conditions, rainfall, this kind of details. So this is the typical example for complicated system. So now I think the electrical on-off system, it is a simple, just an example. Again, I want to explain another system about the driving system. Yeah, driving system of an automobile. I know driving system of the automobile, it's having number of components like accelerator, carburetor, engine, vehicle, like this, where command signal is the force on acceleration pedal. Here we are giving command in the acceleration pedal. Whenever you are applying acceleration pedal, then vehicle it is moving. And you look at here is the acceleration pedal, and the automobile speed is controlled variable. There, whenever you are pressing the accelerator, speed is increased. Whenever you want to reduce the speed, just release the acceleration pedal, speed is getting decreased. The desired change in the engine speed can be obtained by controlling pressure of the accelerator. That's what I said. Whenever you want to speed, that is mean control means either increase or decrease the speed. Whenever you want to increase the speed, just apply the more pressure to the accelerator pedal, so that vehicle will go fast. Whenever now you are at highest speed position, now you are traveling, suddenly you have seen an obstacle, or you want to cross the some place where the people cloud is more. Now what to do? You need to release the pressure from the acceleration pedal, so that your vehicle speed is getting decreased. So that this is the way you can control. This is the typical example for your automobile driving system. You look at this diagram. You have a signal force, it is given by the driver. You have an input command. You have accelerator pedal, linkages, carburetor, everything. You have an engine vehicle. Now if you are giving command, the output is controlled. Output is controlled, that is variable speed. For example, you are taking a vehicle, you cannot go with constant speed. Right, whenever traffic is very less, you can go with higher speed. Whenever traffic is moderate, you can go with moderate. Whenever there is a heavy traffic, we need to go very slowly. So like that, we need to operate the vehicle with variable speed. Then an automobile steering system where the driver is required. Another automobile steering system. So auto automobile steering system. This also you have a good control over the system. An automobile steering system where driver is required to keep the automobile in appropriate lane on the roadways. The eyes measure the output. heading the automobile, the brain and hands react any error existing between the input, the output signal, and act to reduce error to zero. Here you look at this diagram, you have a direction of the car. Here this is your driver eyes. Driver eyes, it is acting like a sensor. Based on the response, then we are giving signal to the brain. Your eyes are watching. If any disturbance is there, it is signaling to the brain. Then what happened? The eye sense, then brain, it will make a plan how to overcome the error. Then brain is giving instruction to the hands. Then the hand operating the serial steering wheel. So finally, the car position is controlled. Otherwise, I can give an explanation. Now, for example, your vehicle is going with 70 kilometers per hour. Your dog is crossing. Your dog is crossing on the road. Now, what happened? The driver, he will sense. He will sense by the eyes. Then what happened? You look at the dog's current position. Based on that, whether we can move the vehicle slightly left or right based on the position of the dog. Now, based on the revision, now currently you are going with speed with the straight. Now, after seeing this obstacle, or that is the dog, you need to making slight turn either left side or right side. So that error, it is corrected. Brain will take a decision. Suppose brain is taking decision, I want to take the vehicle, take a little left turn, then again going to normal. So brain, it is instructing to the hands, then hands is operated, is operating the steering wheel. Finally, the steering wheel is turned left side, so that entire vehicle will turn left side to avoid the accident, right? So this is called position. Then this way you can control the position of the car. Now, for another control system is biological control system. When a person moves this finger to point towards an object, the command signal is position of the object, output signal actually pointed direction. Other well-known examples of control system, you have a electrical frying pan, water supply pressure regulator, toilet tank, water level, electrical irons, refrigerator, household furnace, with the thermostatic control like this. So I want to demonstrate how the biological control system operates. Biological control system, a person pointing towards an object. Here you are positioning the finger, right? Positioning the finger based on the based on our requirement. Then the brain, it is giving instruction based on the position of the finger. The brain, it will observe and it will take a decision what to do, right? If any error comes, the brain will think how to overcome the error. So finally, brain, it will take a decision. After taking decision, then this is communicated to the arms and hands. So finally, then what happened? From the hand, the finger available with the hand, it will take a movement. So this is the biological control system. Next, I talk about the classification of the control system, open loop control system and closed loop control system. Here the difference between the open loop and control system, I clearly demonstrate with two diagrams. Open loop controller, driver, motor. This is like automobile. Open loop controller is a driver, motor. So these are all the three components. But if you look at this, you cannot get any feedback from the motor. So just open loop controller is there. Driver, whatever activity he do, that is final. We will not get any feedback from the system, right? Similarly, closed loop control system, it is little bit different. You have a same component, controller, driver and motor. Here the advantage is, whenever for example driver, he switch on the motor, right? He need to sense if you are getting signal motor rotation. If he found, then what happened? Motor is running. Suppose he switched on, motor is not running. So that feedback, that information to be reached to the controller. That information need to be reached. So this feedback system is very important for error correction. Otherwise, there is no feedback control system, it is very difficult to identify the fault or fault diagnosis, everything, it is not possible. Now, by using this table, I am going to compare the open and closed loop gain, closed loop system. Here, an open loop system has the ability to perform accurately if its calibration is good. Right, if our calibration is good, it is very accurate. If the calibration is not perfect, it is a performance will go down. So the performance degradation, everything, we are not able to understand. We are not able to realize. That is the problem with the open loop system. Whereas in closed loop system has got the ability to perform accurately because of feedback. So here, if your calibration is good, your system is good, there is no problem. We can go ahead with open loop system. Suddenly, if anything, the real-time system, it is not possible. Over the period of time, definitely, we need to have a feedback to rectify the things. Whereas in closed-loop system, has an ability to perform accurately because of feedback. So even though system is not good, but you are getting feedback, that information, it will help you to correct the system. So that feedback is very important. So generally, all the systems, everybody, they will prefer the closed loop system because of the feedback. If any final minute error is there, definitely we can, based on the feedback, we can change. Here I want to give a typical example to compare. Now we are in comparing phase of open loop and closed loop system. For example, you take a driver. Here what happened, driver, based on the feedback, he is taking the distance, he is taking the decision. Otherwise, we cannot use the robo driver for particularly roads, particularly road transport, train transport similarly. Still, we have a lot of technology. We are launching vehicle to space, like moon, different places we are sending vehicle. We have a lot of unmanned vehicle is there. We have a lot of technology. However, we cannot have a robo as a driver in trains and bus, right? It is not possible because it's always the closed loop system. It is completely risk free, so which is associated with a lot of humans, like road transport, particularly like trucks or buses, passenger buses or trains. So here people, they will not use the robot because based on the feedback, immediately we need to sense and correct accordingly. So this is the good system. Then coming to the second point, it is easier to build. So open loop system, it is very easy to build. Just assembling all the component required, you can build it. But here, closed loop system, making the system, it is very difficult to build. It is very difficult to build, difficult to make, because we need to get where to get the feedback system, which particular point. You have a lot of components in your assembly. At which particular component it will give the feedback to us, that need to be identified. Then we need to develop the mechanism to get the feedback, and we need to have another mechanism to correct the error. So these are all associated, so that when compared to open loop system, the closed loop system have a complicate because of the feedback. In general, more stable as feedback is absent. In general, more stable. So coming to the third point, in general, it is more stable as a feedback is absent. Less stable comparatively when stability of the system. They are talking in terms of stability, less stable when compared to open loop system. And then fourth point, if non-linearity are present, the system operation is not good. For example, there is a system, then it will be running with the instantaneous event, or that is associated with a lot of unexpected event. Then if you have some non-linear or your system associated with a lot of unexpected system, then the operation, this system, closed loop, open loop system, it will not sufficient. Even under the presence of non-linearity, that means it is associated with the lot of disturbance or a scope for a lot of error. So this will give the better performance than the open loop system. Then finally, here there is no feedback system. Here feedback is present. Open example for open loop system, you have a traffic control system, control of furnace for coal heating, coal heating, it does not require any feedback. So here we need to identify whether the system really required the closed loop or really required some feedback, then only we can go that, then only it is economic, closed loop system is economic. Otherwise we can go ahead, then control of furnace for coal heating, then an electrical or electric washing machine. So these are all the open loop system. In between we cannot change anything. Then the example for a closed loop system, you have a pressure control system. For example, you have a pressure cooker is there, you are keeping a weight inside, rice, water, everything we are keeping while boiling. Then what happened, the weight automatically it is released and steam is allowed to go away. So this is the feedback. Whenever pressure is increased within a particular limit, then immediately what happened, the weight will be released, so that steam will get the path to go away, so that finally the system comes to equilibrium position. Closed loop system is speed control. Like I said earlier, we cannot put the robot driver for bus and trains. Then robot control system is completely closed loop. Robot control system used in manufacturing assembly, this kind of problem. Then closed loop system is the temperature control system. Even you have a air conditioner, everything, there is an indicator. Based on the temperature available, we need to adjust the indicator. It is the feedback device. So similarly, the comparison between open closed loop system, you can develop lot of points, n number of points. From 5 I discussed many points, so I am expecting you to write if the question is asked. Then we will look at the some of the advantages and the limitations, features of the open loop system. It is very simple to construction as we seen in comparison, and it is very easy to maintain because there is no complicated element to track and trace. There is no stability problem. There is no stability problem in particularly open loop system. Then convenient when the control variable is either difficult to measure or economically not feasible. System is affected internal and external disturbance. The output may differ from desired value. Needs frequent and careful calibration for accurate result. This is very important. We need to frequently we need to calibrate. We need to ensure the system functioning. So otherwise, it is very difficult to control. So this is the some of the features of open loop system. Then coming to the closed loop system, the main features of closed loop system. So we have a comparative discussion, almost we discussed everything. Now again we need to look at some features. This comparison between actual, that means controlled, and the desired value of the variable, to accomplish it, the output signal feedback and the loop is completed. So here the closed loop control system always have a loop. So here the monitoring, control, if error comes to rectify. So these are all the corrective action, everything is possible. The point B, which says that the error in signal, that means deviation between the reference input and the feedback signal. Then the actuate the control element. Whenever the error comes, that means desired is different from actual, automatically the control system is activated in order to minimize the error and bringing the system output to the desired value. Then third point, the system operation is continuously correcting any error that may exist. So the error correction, it's a continuous process, not just correcting one error and allowing the system go. It's not like that. It is a continuous process. Each and every moment the error is identified, right? That is rectified, and finally, it is continued to work in the required state. So as long as the output does not coincide with the desired code, there is a likely to be same kind of the actuating signal. That means whenever the error comes, immediately the actuator, that means the control system is activated. Feedback signal, if you are getting, the output is differing from the expected, immediately the control system is activated. So this is the various features of the closed loop control system. The again, the performance of the such system is evaluated with reference to following desirable characteristics. Here, the minimum deviation following a disturbance. So there is a minimum deviation following a disturbance. Then minimum time interval before return to set point. Minimum offset due to change in operating position. So here, the closed loop control system is again further discussed into. Discussed with the flow chart, so flow chart or control chart. So I request this, the students to use this kind of block diagram to explain the open system, closed loop system, so that you can impress the examiner. And in syllabus it is clearly mentioned, explain with the block diagram like that. So if you are explaining all your concept with the block diagram, drawing block diagram and giving description, so it is the right practice, particularly for this particular topic. So you take a driving system of an automobile. It's a manually controlled automobile. You have a desired speed, driver's eye and brain. So this is also a component. Then drivers and eyes, what happened? It is sending signal to leg muscles, so that he is applying more force on the accelerator pedal. So that what happened, engine vehicle, the output speed is increased or decreased. So whenever an obstacle comes, or whenever they want to take any turn, any turning, then immediately driver eye, it will look at, it will send the information to the brain. So brain, it will send a message to the leg muscle as well as the steering for fingers or hand. Then finally, then what happened, it will, hand, it will operate the steering. Here, the leg muscles, it is increasing or decreasing the force. So finally, speed of the engine vehicle is controlled. So here, speedometer is a feedback signal, particularly in the automobiles while it is in running. You are running with some speed, we need to know whether we are going for slow speed, moderate speed, high speed. So this indication is required. Suppose if you are going with very high speed, the driver's eye, it is looking, there is a right turn after another 100 meters away, immediately what to do? We need to reduce the speed little bit and take a turn. Otherwise, if you are going with the usual speed, then vehicle may skid. So, this is the typical example. So, this block diagram, which clearly explains what is meant by closed loop system and how to get the feedback. So, you can discuss with automobile. So when I am requesting the students, whenever this question is asked, you explain with the block diagram and real-time example, so that you can impress upon the examiner. Then some examples of the closed-loop system. So already the automobile is one of the system. It's a thermal system in closed-loop and automobile driving system. So these are all the examples. Thermal control system on the automobile. Automobile already we have seen. Yeah, thermal control system, it's like your air conditioner or refrigerator, right? Based on the environment temperature, set the temperature inside. If it is a winter, we need to increase the temperature. If it is a summer, we need to decrease the temperature. So this is the way you can control the temperatures. Then before going to the servo mechanism and the elements, detailed discussion about the element, we need to check out the automatic control system. Automatic control system is nothing but wherever we need not employ the human need. We need not employ the human, that system is called as an automatic control system. Of course, it is called as automation. So automation, what happened, it is developed to reduce the human error while manufacturing, while assembling, while processing, etc. And second requirement is, wherever we cannot employ the human, so there we can use some automatic control system. Robot is the best example for automation or automatic control system. For example, robo, we can use the warhead welding process. Manually, if you are doing warhead welding process, it will cause some accidents. Or we can use the robo for some danger, welding some components, radio emission component. For example, the TIG welding process, if you are welding a particular grade of titanium alloy, The welder frequently he will affect, immediately he will affect with cancer, skin cancer. So this is the bigger problem. Day to day the problems are coming out. So this kind of case, what happened? We can develop some automatic system so that whatever work need to perform by the human, that need to be replaced with the robot. So here the requirement of automatic system, it is very clear. One is wherever the human, it is very difficult to work, or the environment is may take fire, or environment have more wind, more dusty, this kind of place we can employ the robot. Here automatic, now I will come for an example. Automatic feedback control thermal system, we are going to see the human operator has seen replace the automatic controller. The actual temperature of hot water is measured by a thermometer feed into the controller for comparison. The reference temperature whose value has been specified appropriate. Whenever the temperature is deviates, so immediately the control system will activate so that it is bring it into the normal. So this is called automatic system. So robot and AGV, automated guided vehicle, these are all the example for automatic control system. So that examples you may be read from automation and robotics subject. This is the typical example for automotive water level control system. And because some of the university question paper they are asking automated design for automatic control system to develop the automatic control system for water level control or pressure control. So this kind of questions may ask with the exam. Here you have a tank, you have a controller, here you have a pneumatic valve. So this is a water level control system. Here what happened, you have a controller. So here your big container, your water is coming out through this way. This is your pneumatic valve. Here this is the outlet of the water. Here you have a controller, automatic controller. Here how this water controller control system works. So here water flow continuously coming. The water flow is not constant, it is variable. Whenever water flow rate is very high, so that what happened, the tank it will be filled. Whenever reaching a particular limit, immediately here this is a rubber ball, it's a float. So whenever the float reached the required height, then immediately the controller system is activated. So whenever a control system is activated, the activated control system, it will reduce the speed of the water. So that coming, reaching, then what happened, water level is reduced. So that water flow rate is very less, so we can avoid the overflow. For example, here, suddenly one particular tank, the outlet flow is very high, so that the flow is going to bottom out basin. At the same time, we should not allow any empty water. Whenever the ball is or float is reached the minimum diameter, immediately the controller is activated, the pneumatic valve it is opened, so that we are expecting higher flow water. So this is the typical water level control system, automated water level control system. Then another one is pressure control system. Pressure control system, already I explained the pressure cooker. So here how it works. Here you have a furnace. Here you have a burner. You are supplying oil, air, and you are igniting so that temperature is generated. So here you have a damper. Whenever the temperature increases based on your Boyle's law, pressure will increase. Once the pressure is reached into particular level, then you have a pressure relief valve, so that that valve, what happened, immediately the control system is activated, so that pressure inside the furnace is getting released. Otherwise, if you are continuously increasing the temperature or not activating the control system, or if it is open control system, open system, then furnace it will be blasted. So it will cause a big accident. So we need to have a control system. But here pressure indicator, it is a mechanism for feedback. Here water level is the indicator for the what is called, it's a feedback control. Water level is the feedback. Here pressure level is the feedback device. Next I will come to the advantages and limitation of automated system, suitability and desirability in complex and fast acting system. Then relief to human being from the physical work. Then economy in operating cost due to elimination of continuous employment. Then increased output and productivity. Of course, the automated system, the productivity output is always more. I want to put an example in this point. there is a automobile chase manufacturing company, Ashok Leyland is there. One of the employee from the Ashok Leyland, he is telling one particular place, they are using industry 4.0 technology, that incorporate the technology, robot, control everything. So because of the advanced manufacturing system, the productivity, it is increased by 256%. So this is the real time example. Improvement in quality, quantity, so product. So economic economy in the plant equipment, power requirement, and it is process material. The feedback permit. So here automatic system, the feedback permit to initiate the precise control. Then reduced effect of non-linearities and distortion. Satisfactory response over wide range of frequency. If you want to talk about the limitation which requires, which creates unemployability, it's a one side, and another one, it is associated with a lot of cost and it is required a lot of maintenance. So these are all the some of the limitations we can quote for the automatic control system. Now I come to the elements of a control system. So controls, what is meant by control system? What is meant by control? What is meant by system? Both we have seen. So we seen the control system also, how it will be worked, classification, everything. Now we need to discuss about various component, that is what is called elements we need to discuss. So this is the particular point, point of the control system. It is helping us to error detector. This is your reference input. You have a reference input. Here you are activating the signal. You have a control elements like G1. Then from the control element, what happened? The manipulated variable, it is going to the plant. So the plant always, you have a disturbance, like the disturbance due to raw material supply or a labor strike. So we will have a many discussions. So finally, what happened? We need to how to overcome this disturbance, or whenever disturbance comes without affecting the output, how to control this? This is our requirement. Here you will get the control output. Suppose if your the output is not controlled or not matched with the reference input, immediately that feedback will be given to the error detector. It will find out the error. What is the difference between the expected output and what is the output achieved? It will compare. Then immediately what happened? The actuator or the error detector, based on the error, immediately the control system is activated so that the output is bring it into the required level. Then we have a component. This question, I think it is an university question paper. I want to discuss each and every element. One is primary feedback signal, a function of control output C, which is compared with the reference input to obtain in the actuating signal. Here primary feedback signal means it is a function of the controlled output whenever it is different from the reference to actual. Then second one is error detector, an element that detects the feedback. Essentially it is summing point, which gives the algebraic summation of two or more signal. The direction of flow of information is indicated by the arrow and the algebraic nature of summation plus or minus signs. The negative feedback occurs when feedback signal subtract from the reference signal. If the feedback signal adds to reference signal, then feedback is said to be positive. E equal to R minus B, E equal to R plus B. So these two equations, it is clearly, which clarifies the negative difference between negative and positive signal. The negative feedback tries to reduce the error, whereas the positive feedback makes the error large. Right? If error is coming in negative value, there is no problem. If error it is getting positive value, even that value also very huge. So we required very huge effort to control the system. Then disturbance. So already what is called, it's undesirable variable applied to the system. This disturbance means already I clearly explained the control system, particularly the automobile example. Whenever you are going sometimes a particular place, every day traffic will be less, and a particular day traffic will be more. So this is a disturbance. It's called unexpected events. And under undesirable variable applied to the system, which tends to affect adversely the value of variable being controlled. The process disturbance may due to changes in set point, supply, demand, environmental and associated variable. This is what I said. Industry, we have a lot of unexpected events. The supplier delay, sometimes the customer arrival, then environmental, sometimes the environmental also it will play, it will create some disturbance like this. The environmental disturbance means particularly foundry. Suddenly the climate condition is very cold, then what happened? The metal, it will go for rapid solidification so that it will get the variation in property. Next, we need to talk about the feedback element. An element feedback control system establishes functional relationship between the control variable and the feedback signal. Then control system is nothing but it is an element that is required to generate appropriate control signal. M is applied to the plant. Then forward and backward path. Transmission path from actuating signal to the controlled output constitute forward path. Then backward path, it is the transmission path from the controlled output to primary feedback. So it is very clear. Actuating signal, control output constitute forward path, the transmission path from actuating to controlled output. If it is comes from control output to primary feedback signal, it is called backward path. So these are all the various components we discussed. So of course, this also an important question. So please understand each and every component and role of the each and every component. Then we need to explain. Now I will go to the last topic about servo control. This topic we are going to discuss what is meant by servo control. By using servo control mechanism, how to measure the temperature, how to measure the position, how to measure the speed. These three things we are going to discuss before closing with the advantages. Servo mechanism, which is little bit different from automatic, but it is an automatic device used to correct the performance of the mechanism by means of error sensing feedback. Of course, normally the servo mechanism, recently you may be studied about electrical discharge machining. So there, if you want to get the desired machining, the gap between the electrode and workpiece, we need to maintain constantly. If it is too close, electrode, it will melt. Electrode, it will melt very quickly. If it is going for a too long distance, then the arc, it will not be inefficiency, so that you cannot get the better machining. So here the term servo mechanism properly applies to only system in which feedback and error correction signal control mechanical position are one of its derivatives such as velocity or acceleration. So the EDM working, the tool control is another example. So that will be discussed further. Then servo mechanism, you have a primary task of servo mechanism is to maintain the output system at the desired value in the presence of disturbance. Even though if disturbance comes or challenges comes, it need to maintain the in the required position. So this is what I am quoting an well-known example of electrical discharge machining. So the tool control, that means maintaining the tool and workpiece gap is maintained by the servo mechanism. If it is optimal distance, then only we can get electrode melting, it will be less, then the metal machining rate, it will be more. Right, so to control the constant gap, servo mechanism is used. So this is the various elements required for required to control the servo, control the mechanism. So already I said I am going to use the speed control, position control, and third one is temperature control. Speed control I am going to explain first, then speed and position control I am going to explain later. Here speed control via governor is another type of servo mechanism. Controlling governor, recently I explained this thing, governor. The governor which governs the speed, that means maintain the constant speed. Here I think prior to Second World War, the constant speed propeller was developed to control the engine speed for maneuvering aircraft. There is aircraft, maintaining constant speed, it is very important. Normally the governors, yeah, these are all used. I think recently we have seen an example in power control. Then this is the typical control system, position control system using the servo mechanism. Here you have a host computer with a motion control unit, then position control unit, you have a servo drive. So based on your requirement, the servo motor, it will give information, it will send a signal to the motor. So that what happened, you can go ahead with increased speed, reduced speed. So whatever table movement required, table speed required, work table required, either it will move this way or this way, right to left, up and down, up and down it is not possible. Right to left movement, front and back movement, both movement you can control with the required speed. So this is the typical example to control and speed. So control means position means you are moving front and back or right to left. This is the position control. Then speed control, how much speed it is, suddenly this will move very quickly or very slowly. So this kind of movement and position you can control by using the servo mechanics. So this is the another diagram which clearly explains the velocity and position. Here you have a tachometer, you have a motor. So tachometer is the feedback mechanism. Earlier automobile, speedometer is the feedback mechanism. Here you have a tachometer. So tachometer continuously it will give the feedback signal whenever the required motor speed is changed. Required, this is the output, the actual output, this is the desired output. Whenever you have a change, immediately what happened, the control system is activated, so that what happened, the speed is managed. So this is the typical example for controlling speed. Then this is position control system, EDM tool position control using servo mechanism I want to demonstrate. Here in servo mechanism, automatically maintain the constant gap between 0.00 inch to 0.01 inch. So this distance is very important. If it is distance is reduced, the electrode, it will get more wear rate. If the distance is too long, then the machining rate will be decreased. So this is the challenge. So that servo mechanism, it is used to maintain the gap between the tool and workpiece within the distance. So this is the electrical discharge machining. Here you have a servo control. Here you have a workpiece. Here what happened, here you look at this, you have a workpiece with the inside the workpiece, this tank is completely with the dielectric fluid. When the servo control mechanism, it will activate. Initially, the machining, it will be started from this position. So whenever the cavity is formed, whenever cavity formation occurred, then what happened, the distance between the workpiece and tool is increased. So again, the servo motor control system is activated and pushes the tool little bit downward direction so that the constant gap is maintained, so until end of the machining. So this is the typical example for position control. Then this is called servo mechanism to use the temperature control. You have a PC, right? Or this is the this is like a EDM mechanism. You have a microprocessor one, microprocessor two. You have a control parameters, electrical source. If you have a servo mechanism, gap between the tool electrode and workpiece is maintained constantly. If the distance is increased or decreased, immediately that information, that feedback information is passed on to the microprocessor. Then the microprocessor, it is instructing, it is activated. And finally, the tool and workpiece gap is maintained constantly. So this is the continuation of electrical discharge machining. Then this is the room temperature control unit. Already I said air conditioner, it is a good example to explain the room temperature control system, servo control system. Here what happened, here you have insulation chamber, right? Here you have actual room temperature, it is available. Here you have a provision to heat loss, heat it will go. Here outside temperature, here actual room temperature is available. This is completely closed. Here we are keeping a thermometer or temperature indicator to measure the room temperature. So here from the temperature device, we can measure the actual temperature. Here we will supply the desired temperature. For example, air conditioner at summer, 14 degree is enough. So here your desired temperature is 14 degree. So that based on the desired temperature, the potentiometer is there that will supply the electrical signal to the control. Based on the control, here gas is then what happened, heat is burned and heat input is supplied along with the gas. So whenever the temperature is more, so system will heat loss, it will be more, so that it is balanced. Whenever the temperature is less, temperature is more, heat loss, temperature is less, again what happened, here you need to go and reduce. So this is the way to control the temperature. I am expecting you people to discuss both diagrams so that it is very easy. Then coming to the final slide, advantages of the servo control system. So So here intermediate motor and control cost, it is associated. It is a continuous duty. For example, EDM until end of the machining, the mark gap is continuously maintained. So that is called the continuous duty. It is reversible. Sometimes that's what I discussed. That's what I discussed. Even electrode also, it will get melt. Right? Electrode also, it will be get worn out because of excessive heat. While EDM, based on if electrode wear rate is there, then it will take a upward moment. Then speed is proportional to the applied voltage. Torque is proportional to the current. It is very efficient. Here, no power is required to hold a static load in position. Then flat feed or torque curve. Here, peak torque is available for short period of time. Then smooth rotation of low speed. Then it will be good up to 3000 RPM. So these are all the advantages. So this is the last topic. So now this is the end of your unit number 5. All the best to the students, thanking you. So again, if time permits, I am going to revise the topic what I discussed now. Thank you. Thank you.